Hi, I'm Lisa. In today's video, I want to talk about something really frustrating: getting your IP banned from a website. If you've ever been blocked from a site and couldn't figure out how to get around it, we're going to break down what causes IP bans and how you can bypass them. So what exactly is an IP ban? Your IP address is like your home address, but for the internet. It's what websites use to identify your device. When a site detects unusual activity, it can block or ban your IP address, preventing you from accessing the site. To ban an IP address, the host will first need to identify your IP and then include it in their blacklist. Websites can use various methods, such as server logs, cookies, and web analytics tools to identify your IP address. Websites might impose an IP ban for various reasons. Too many requests. This usually happens when a site detects that you are sending too many requests in a short time, which is typical with bots or automated tools. Suspicious activity. If your IP is involved in any malicious behavior, like hacking attempts or spamming, the site might ban it to protect its users. Violating terms of service. This could be anything from scraping content without permission, using a bot, or any other activity that the site doesn't allow. So how do you bypass an IP ban? There are several ways to do this, and which one works best depends on the type of ban you are dealing with. While the easiest way is to uninstall and install the banned program again, the second most common method is using a VPN or a proxy. A VPN or virtual private network allows you to mask your real IP address by routing your connection through a server in another location. This effectively changes your IP and lets you access the site again. Similarly, proxies work by acting as a middleman between your device and the site. Instead of visiting the website directly, the proxy does it on your behalf using its own IP. Another easy fix is clearing your cache. Similar to clearing your browser's cache, you can also clean up your computer. Start by heading to your computer's search bar and pasting the following locations. They will be provided to you in the video description. Then identify and delete files related to the program you got your IP banned from. Open the registry by pressing the Windows key plus R and entering regedit. Once you receive a pop-up window, you'll see more locations below. Paste them into the search bar of the registry, locate folders related to the program, and delete them. By doing this, you will eliminate any leftover files from programs that blocked you. A more technical approach would be changing your MAC address. Some bans target specific devices, and changing your MAC address can trick the website into thinking you're using a different device. First, generate a new MAC address with an online MAC address generator. Then go to Device Manager, select Network Adapters, and go to the properties of your Ethernet connection. Navigate to the Advanced Settings and select the Locally Administered Address property. Lastly, paste your newly generated MAC address into value. But if you are looking to avoid IP bans as someone who scrapes data, here's an important tip: use residential proxies. If you are not an individual user but a company, VPNs won't suit your needs the best. Residential proxies route your requests through real devices with legitimate ISPs, making your activity look more like that of a regular user. This significantly reduces the chances of getting banned in the first place. Additionally, proxy management solutions like Web Unblocker might be an excellent option. This AI-powered proxy solution can bypass even the most sophisticated anti-bot systems, preventing your IP from getting banned and allowing you to scrape without interruptions. If you want to avoid getting IP banned in the future, you should respect the website's terms of service. If you are pushing the boundaries, you are more likely to trigger an IP ban. Use VPNs or proxies and proxy solutions to keep your IP fresh to avoid detection. Even though IP bans are really annoying, I hope you found this video helpful. If you've got any questions or your own experiences with IP bans, comment below and we'll be sure to check them out. If you've encountered any problems with IP bans while using our products, email support@oxylabs.io or write us via the live chat on our homepage. Also, consider joining our Discord community where we discuss all things web scraping. Thanks for watching and see you next time.